certainly did. When you start in the TV business, you hope you might get 2 years, and then 4 years, and then 6 years, and then you know it's over. And then I blinked, and it was 15 years. And it was a tremendous privilege. You know, I would do a live show every Friday, but every Thursday I would be told, you're going to get on a plane, you're going to fly to Ottawa, then you're going to get on a smaller plane, you're going to fly to Iqaluit, then you're going to get on a smaller plane, you're going to fly north, then you're going to get on a dog sled, and that's not the shoot. Then you're going to arrive, then you're going to do your shoot. And for 15 years, I got to do that and travel the country and see the country. That was an incredible gift, and a lot of the recollections and reflections are in the moment.
Well, there are so many to share. I mean, everything from how to ride an escalator to some very, you know, heady political discourse. Let's start with the escalator.
Well, you know, the rants always, they originally would always be about politics. But then sometimes, no matter what was happening in the country, something else would be driving me crazy, like the fact that Canadians suddenly seem to not know how to use escalators or elevators. And so I would rant about that. And, you know, sometimes those were the more popular rants because everyone can relate to that.
Well, you have 15 seconds to educate everyone on how to properly ride an escalator.
Well, the rules of the road apply. You stay right, except to pass. So don't weigh anything in the passing lane. And when you ride at the top, don't stop and look around. Pull over to the side.
We'll get to some of the political commentaries and rants in a little while, but you really, really had me doing that unattractive laugh when I read about it, and this is a laugh out loud read, most certainly. Snow tires. That guy in the audience, that scene on that winter day in Toronto, really funny.
Well, that's a true story. This guy almost killed me, and he slid past me in an Audi, and it went, he just kept sliding, and slammed into this pole. And I asked him, I said, do you have snow, when he got out, I said, what, don't you have snow tires on? And he said, I don't need them, I've got all season radials. Like, after he just slid through an intersection into a pole. And, okay, you're covered.
The line that made me laugh, he said, how can a guy who has a job that where he can afford a $57,000 car, how can he not have snow tires?
Yeah.
But, you know, you've spent time with, and you've taken those hard jabs at all political parties. You've had some really interesting adventures with, you know, our political leaders and our celebrities. I'd love to just talk about that for a moment.
Sure.
Pierre Bergen.
Well, Pierre Bergen came on the show and rolled a joint. And that was very early in our tenure because we became a family show. And I didn't realize that we started, we were a family show. So in the first year, I wanted someone to roll a joint. Pierre Burton rolled a joint. I called him up cold. I said, Mr. Burton, will you come on the television and roll a joint? He said, I can do that. He said, but you have to bring the weed. And I didn't. So I had to score weed for Pierre Burton. I don't even smoke weed. Someone took care of it. And when I met him the next day, the first thing he said was, did you bring the weed? And then we shot the piece, and he was tremendous, and I got to thank him for turning me on to Canadian history, and I read all his books, and signed all my books. He's a total gentleman, and the final thing that he said to me was, leave the weed.
Now, it might have been oregano, is that true?
No.
We should say that
that's not the way we roll.
Yeah. It was so important to you to have Pierre Burton as that person, because you long admired him. But
well,
how about... Sorry.
Yes.
Shirley Douglas.
Well, Shirley Douglas is a dear friend of mine, and Shirley Douglas is Tommy Douglas's daughter. And we used to do these things, celebrity tips, and so Shirley came on the show and taught Canadians how to properly boost a car. And for those who are familiar with Shirley, the granddad, the actress, she is perfectly coiffed at all times. And it was the middle of the night, it's 30 below, and she knew exactly how to boost a car. And she told, you know, she taught Canadians, and she's a tremendous friend, and I mean, speaking of Ottawa, of course, she was Tommy Douglas's daughter, and she's a great storyteller, and my entire, for the last decade, she's told me so many great stories about Ottawa in that era with Tommy Douglas, since it was great to have her on the show.
And JJ and Michael would love to know that after she boosted the car, she said, would you like me to show you how to change a tire?
Absolutely.
You have Margaret Atwood taking shots. There are so many more stories to share, and we will share them